Hey guys, Balkan Architect here, and today's video is going to be dedicated to Revit stairs and stairs only. So I wanted to have this video where I'm just going to go over kind of the basic setup of stairs in Revit, and then also I'm going to be covering some advanced stairs features and some tips that you really want to know, things that were really annoying to me, things like, for example, how to change the type of stairs, how it looks. So we're just going to be taking a regular stair and then improving it. Also, I'm going to be showing you how to get rid of that ugly zigzag line, you know, that line that appears. I'm going to show you how to turn that into a nice, elegant straight line. And then finally, I'm also going to be showing you how to connect a concrete stair to the top floor in a, well, more elegant way than it's usually done inside of Revit. So that's the topic of this video. And yeah, that's what we're going to be talking about. Now, if you want to learn more about stairs and railings as well, I have a whole dedicated course to both stairs and railings. I'm going to link it just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. It's on my website, balkanarchitect.com. There you can find all of my advanced Revit courses, beginner courses, intermediate courses, but also advanced courses. I have over 120 hours of content. I'm adding more each week. And also there you can find my customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families and also a plugin. Okay, so just one more thing before we start with the video. Make sure to like this video, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell icon. It helps me out a lot, it helps you not miss any of my future videos, and most importantly, it makes the alpaca happy, and that's why we're all here. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump into Revit. And as you can see, here I am at Revit's kind of homepage. Let's go here to new. And for the template file, as I said, I have my own customized templates. I'm just going to be using the custom Balkan Architect template, the metric version, and I'm just going to click OK. If you want to find it, I'm going to link it up above in the cards. Okay, so now, as soon as Revit starts up, we're going to be creating our first stair. Okay, so the stair tool, it's here on the Architecture tab under Circulation. There we have the stair tool. So before you get started with the stair tool, you want to make sure that your levels are set up correctly. Now, I just like to go here into the one of the elevations. Here it's at 3.6. Let's say this is a bit too much. Let's say we want to go with 3.1. So I'm just going to add that. And one more thing, I'm just going to add a few more levels, and I'm going to explain why I'm doing this in just a minute or two. But let's add a few levels like this. Hit the escape key a few times and let's go back to level one. Okay, once we have the stair, the levels created, now we can create the stairs. So go to the stair tool, you click there, and then here you choose the stair type. Now by default, I think you're going to have three or four. Here, because this is part of my template, you can see that you have a bit of a wider range. And I'm just going to go with the 190mm max riser, 250mm going. This is a default stair, you get this with Revit, so everybody should have this one on hand. And once you select the stair type, then you want to select how many stairs are going to be there. So stairs obviously go from one level to the other level, and here you can specify the desired number of risers. So risers, those are kind of the vertical part of the stair. So how many of those kind of vertical elements should you have? So here it's going to basically divide the elevation between two levels by this number, and that's going to give you actual riser height. So the height of that height difference between the stairs. So here it's saying this is 0.18, so that's 18 centimeters. If I drop this down to 16 and hit apply, it's going to be higher because less steps means higher risers. And also it's going to give you this warning saying that you've exceeded the maximum riser height specified in the family. So if you go here into edit type, here you can actually specify what's the maximum height. And if you go past that, Revit is going to give you a warning and say, well, no, you don't want to go past that. Usually you want to set this up according to your local regulations and rules, and you want to follow that. But if you don't want to listen to that, you can go and specify like 15, hit apply, this is like 20 centimeters. And if I just click OK, Revit is going to be like, yeah, go ahead. Who cares? It's your funeral. So anyways, I suggest you don't overdo it. So I'm just going to go with 18 here, hit apply. That gives us 17.2. That's perfectly comfortable for stairs. And this is the tread depth. So that's the length of each step. You can specify that as well. I can leave it as is. And now we're just going to go here to the straight line and start creating our first stair. So you click once, and then once you click, you can see at the bottom, it's going to report how many risers, so those vertical elements, have you created and how many are remaining to get to the upper floor. Now, in this case, I purposely went with 18 because that's an even number, because then I can have two stair runs. So I can go like this, see how it says 9 created, 9 remaining. I can click there and I have one stair run, and then I can move off to the side, click again and place the rest of them. And as you can see, they are now equal length. This is something that you might see in a residential house or an office building or something like that, where both runs are equal. And this is how you create it. Now you can use the arrow keys to kind of move things around. You can resize the width of the risers here. And also you can flip this around. So if I just go here to the 3D view, this is what that looks like. So this is our stair. Now, if I wanna flip this around, I can just go here to the tools, go to flip, and it's going to flip it to the other side. So if you accidentally put it the other way around, you can always flip it. That's kind of available there. Also, one more thing that's really important is the railing. Usually you can specify the railing later on, but I prefer to do it now. You just click on railing, you get this little menu, and then you can pick out which railing style or type you want to use. And also here you can specify, do you want to place it on treads, which is this kind of structural part here, or on stringers, or sorry, treads are the steps, or the stringers, which is the structural part of the stairs. So you can place it wherever you want. I'm just going to leave it at treads. Okay, so those are some of the main settings. Also, you have connect levels. Now, this is if you have a stair that doesn't go from level 1 to level 2, but it also goes all the way up to, in this case, level 5. So you just go here to connect levels. You can go to your south elevation, and then you can just select these levels and hit finish. And now that stair is going to go all the way up. So you do have that option, and it's really cool. And also, then you can modify the whole thing however you want later on. Now I'm just going to go back because I don't actually want that multi-story or multi-level stair. Hit finish, and it's just going to... Okay, I should have gone back a couple of times, I think. There we go, hit finish. There we go. And we get the railing here. Now I'm actually going to just get rid of the railing because I don't need it for this particular tutorial. And now let's continue exploring some of the options. So if I select this stair, I can go here into edit type, and now I can modify this stair family. Now, stair families are very complicated. That's why I have like a whole, I think it's like a 5-hour course on stairs and railings, just because they're complicated families. They are both system families and component families brought together, which makes them, well, complicated, as I said. But I am going to show you a few little tricks. So for example, the run type, that's the type of this kind of one run of stairs, you can customize that here. So you can click here, and then you can make some customizations. So you can customize your tread material, your riser material. So treads, as I said, the horizontal part, risers, the vertical part. And then also here you can specify them even further, set up the dimensions and so on. In this case, I'm just going to get rid of the risers, and then when I hit apply and OK, and then apply and OK, it's going to look like this. See? No, none of those vertical elements. And I think it looks kind of elegant and nice like this. Also, if I go back here, you can do the same thing for the landing. So the landing is that horizontal part. So for that, you can customize this and you can have it same as the run, or you can uncheck that and then you can customize its material, the dimensions and so on. I'm just going to make it the same as the run. And one more thing, the reason why I'm explaining what's what on the stair is because English isn't the first language for me, and that and I found that I just not knowing the kind of proper architectural terminology can make things really difficult inside of Revit. So that's why I kind of want to explain all of those things. Yeah, that's why I'm saying it. Anyways, finally here we have the supports, so this is also really important. Currently we have these stringers on both sides, and here the right and left supports are stringers. Now you can uncheck them, so you can make them none, and hit apply, click OK, so it would look like this. Now obviously this wouldn't work, so what I am going to do is come in here, and I'm just going to give it a middle support. Yes, you can do that. Not many people know about this, but it is quite important. I didn't know about this for the first 2 years of working in Revit. And then you can customize that middle support. I'm not going to, I'm just going to make sure that it's there. And as you can see, this is what that looks like then, and it looks a lot better with that, just that middle support. Okay, click OK here, and then let's go into level 1. So currently this is what this stair looks like. Now let's talk about this ugly zigzag. This is something that I truly hate, and I don't know why this is done like this. We don't do it like this in my country. Perhaps you do it in your country. Please stop doing it. It's ugly. So how do we fix this? Well, you select the stair, you go into Edit Type, and then here inside of the Edit Type menu, towards the bottom you have graphics, and here it says cut mark type, and currently it says single zigzag. Now you can click here to open up that family, the line family, and you can customize it. So for example, you can have double line like this, so you can have two lines, or you can have double zigzag and so on. So let me show you how to build this. So I'm just going to duplicate this and call this one the new cool line. Click OK. Okay, so here you want to have two lines, so double line. You don't want to have it zigzag, so you just set it to none. This is the cut angle, so at which angle it is. I'm just going to leave it like that. Cut line extension, I like to have an extension, so I'm just going to go with 1.2 millimeters. And cut line distance, so the distance between two lines, I'm going to leave that at 1 millimeter. Then if I click OK, if I hit apply, click OK, it's going to look like this. And let's be honest, it looks much, much cooler. I mean, I'm not going to say that the zigzag line is good. This is much better. Okay, so I'm quite happy with the way that this turned out. And finally, one more thing that I would like to show you is how to connect properly your stairs with the floor above. So let me show you the issue first, and then I'm going to explain how to fix it. So I'm going to go here to level 2, and then in the level 2, let's create the floor. Just a simple floor like this. Perfect. Okay, and now let's create the stair that goes up to this floor. So go back to level 1, let's go to the stair tool, and here I'm just going to go with the monolithic stair, and actually I can go with the office building stair, that's my customized stair, customized monolithic stair, and then let's just go like this from level 1 up to level 2, and then hit finish. See how we have this kind of nice cut line here. So anyways, let's now move forward, go to level 2 and just make sure we attach this. So just go to the move tool, attach it like that, perfect. And now let's go to the section. Okay, this is a terrible section. So let's try that again. Make sure you create a straight section, just like that, perfect. Open that up. And this is what we have. So here, see how this stops kind of weirdly here? And you usually you don't want that. So you can go here into Edit Stairs, you can select this, and then you can use this little drag and button and drag it out by one extra step. And also what you can do here as well, select this, and you see how I have this little riser? The reason for that is because this stair, if I just hit finish, this stair, see how it has like concrete on the bottom, and then it has these kind of stone, a stone finish. That's just something that's included in my template. Looks really cool, but when you want to connect it like this, you have that ugly stone just kind of, well, making people trip. You can actually turn that off by selecting the stair, going into Edit Stairs, You can select that stair, and then here you have the option with end with riser, and you just uncheck that, hit apply, and as you can see, that is now gone. And then you can just hit finish. And of course, you have to modify the floor here, go into edit boundary, use pick lines like that. Perfect. Then go with split element. Oops, I didn't check this. Okay, perfect. And now you hit finish, and there we go. So now the stair is connecting properly. Of course, you can match the same material here to the material of that top riser or the top step. So you can do that. That's going to make it look a lot nicer. But there you go. That's how you solve that really, really annoying issue where the stairs kind of are dangling in air and not properly connected to the floor above as you would connect it in real life. So there you go. I hope you have learned one or two new things about stairs. I hope you have enjoyed this video. As I said, please make sure to like this video, make sure to subscribe, and please tell me in the comment section below the video, did you enjoy this, and do you have some of your own custom tips about stairs in Revit? Also, as I said, make sure to check out my website. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.